The paracellular cells of the thyroid gland that releases one of the hormones calcitonin, or that another name is thyrocalcitonin. So it is the function of it is one of the hypocalcemic or hypophosphatemic. So when the calcium ions and phosphate ions are very less in the blood, then it is increased by the calcitonin. Okay, so that is the hypocalcemic and hypophosphatemic. So they are imbalanced by the, or balanced by the these thyrocalcitonin. So it is one of the antagonistic hormone to the parath hormone. Okay, so let's see that another hormone is parath hormone. Parat hormone, parathyroid hormone. Or gland, parathyroid gland. So it is also endodermal origin. So there are four parathyroid glands are present. Okay, right. So the parathyroid gland is located at the backside of thyroid gland. So these parathyroid hormone, thyroid gland secretes a hormone is called as parathyroid hormone. Right? So these parathyroid hormone regulates or controls the calcium levels in the circulatory fluids. Right? So here the parathyroid hormone, so it is helps to the reabsorption of the calcium ions from the renal tubule of kidney. See here once, so the parathyroid hormone, and it increases the calcium ions in the digestive calcium, increases the absorption rate of the calcium ions in the digestive food, and it promotes the calcium formation of the calcitrate. So that is the active form of the D vitamin. See here once, let's again I can explain this parathyroid gland. So it is the endodermal origin. So here generally four parathyroid glands are present in the body. So it is located the region of backside of the thyroid gland. So the parathyroid gland that secretes the one of the hormone that is called parat hormone, or another name is parathyroid hormone. So the parathyroid hormones controls or regulates the calcium ions in the circulatory fluids. Okay, so the parathyroid hormones will helps to the reabsorption of the calcium ions from the renal tubule of kidney, and the parathyroid hormone, it increases the calcium ions in the increases the absorption of the calcium ions in the digestive food, and the parathyroid hormone, it stimulates the formation of calcitrate. So that is the active form of the D vitamin. Okay, so let's see that another hormone is thymus gland. Another gland is thymus gland. See once, thymus So it is the hormone, it is the globular structure, structured hormone. So it is located at the above of the heart and aorta, and beneath the breast bone. So the thymus gland, it is the globular structure hormone. It is located at the heart region and aorta of the heart and beneath the breast bone. So these thymus gland releases one of the hormone is that thymosin. So these thymus glands, it initiates and it is the main function as the systematical function as that increases the immune system in the body. So the thymus gland release one of the hormone is the thymosin. So this thymosin is helps to play a major role to increases the differentiation of T lymphocytes that results to the causes of cell mediated immunity. And this tyrosine hormone that helps to promoting the production of antibodies, so that produce the humoral immunity. See once here, so the thymus gland is releases or secretes the one of the hormone is thymosin. So this thymosin is helps to participation and increasement of the differentiation of T lymphocytes, so that is causes to the cell mediated immunity, and it promotes the thymosin hormone that promotes the production of antibodies. So these antibodies are involved and the response to produce the humoral immunity. Okay, so let's see that another hormone is pancreas. So it is the hormone that is it acts as the exocrine hormone and as well as endocrine hormone. So generally it is called as heterocrine hormone. So why it is called heterocrine hormone? That means it functions as the exocrine hormones functions and as well as endocrine hormone functions. It can be done by these two types of characteristics. Okay, so here the pancreas of the exocrine parts of the pancreas consist of the acini cells. So here the exocrine part of the pancreas consists of the acini cells. So these acini cells will helps to develop the digestive enzymes. Okay, so right here the endocrine part of the pancreas, it consists of the islets of Langerhans. So generally in human body or human pancreas, nearly 1 or 2 million of islets of Langerhans are present in the pancreas. Okay, so it has two characteristics, that one is exocrine hormone and endocrine characteristic. So generally it is called as heterocrine hormone. So the part of the exocrine pancreas consists of the acini cells. So which helps to production of the digestive enzymes, and the endocrine part of the pancreas consists of the isolates of Langerhans. So these Langerhans nearly 1 or 2 million present in the human pancreas. Here the isolates of Langerhans in the cells of isolates of Langerhans are four types. The cells of the Langerhans, isolates of Langerhans are four types. They are, first one is alpha cells, second one is beta cells, third one is delta cells,